Now to the simplest thing that we know can work, masks. How much of how much of optimism, let's say, should be derived from the wearing of masks? And there are many questions related to masks. So let me first ask you, are masks really the game changers that they're made out to be?
Exactly, yes. And I would say by this, what do you think Taiwan has? Do you think Taiwan has a better treatment or a vaccine? How did Taiwan control the disease? And I can name 15 countries, right? The mm-hmm. important thing for us to remember is there are countries out there that are living normal lives, that have full stadiums and having sports going on. How did they do that? By trace, test, trace, and isolate. So masks help. Imagine if you have droplets coming out of your face. Every time we talk, we sing, we cry, we laugh, there are micro droplets that we emit. If I'm wearing a mask, you are protected from that droplets. So the biggest advantage of a mask is it protects people around us. But when we do it all as a community, then my mask protects you and your mask protects me and essentially kills the virus.
But there are questions related to this, right? When you go for a walk, and you know, in India, public spaces are now, because people are fed up of sitting inside, and as we unlock, people are going out for a walk, they're going out for a run. In Mumbai, we had a very tragic story of somebody who was jogging, who was running with his mask on, and he died, right? When I walk, because I walk in an open space and there's not someone immediately close to me, I have to say I do not wear my mask because I feel claustrophobic. Should you be wearing a mask while walking or running? Nobody has clarity on this.
Yeah, so, and I know some people will be unhappy no matter what I say on this, but I'm going to tell you what I think the science says.
Yeah.
If you're out there walking, running, I don't think you need to wear a mask because your encounters are such fleeting encounters with others. Exposure, high exposure is when both parties are not wearing a mask, they're within 6 feet of each other for more than 10 to 15 minutes, not seconds. When you're in a park, that's a fleeting encounter. You're around each other for half a second. So I personally do not think masks are necessary. But that tragic story, I think it's very, very difficult as a physician for me to accept that the mask had anything to do with that death. I could be masked and drop dead because I had a heart attack or an embolism in my lung. So I think that's a coincidence and we should not link it to wearing the mask.
Fair enough. But you would say that in an open space where you're not running into people at close encounters for any significant length of time, a mask is not necessary, which takes me to the CDC confusion over the aerosol spread. What do we know? Does this virus spread through the air or not? And is the 6 feet distance, 6 gaz ki duri, jo yahan bola jata hai, kya wo kafi hai ya nahi, Fahim sahab?
जी, 6 गज की दूरी बिल्कुल काफ़ी है क्योंकि अगेन जिन मुल्कों ने इस जंग को जीता है वो 6 गज की दूरी से जीता है. द इशू ऑफ एरोसोल इज वंस अगेन इन दैट 10% वेयर वी डोंट नो एवरीथिंग, बट दिस इज व्हाट वी डू नो. इट हैपेंस अंडर सर्टन सर्कमस्टांसेस. व्हाट दैट इज, इफ आई हैव कोविड एंड इफ आई एम हाईली इन्फेक्शियस एंड आई एम सिटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ एन एयर कंडीशनर इन अ क्लोज्ड स्पेस इन अ रेस्टोरेंट. Of course, that's common sense that air current is now going to take my droplets more than 6 feet away. You don't need a study for that. That's common sense, right?
Yeah.
So if you have a patient and you and his COVID positive and you're putting a tube in their lung and just churning everything up, of course, they're going to cough and this aerosolization is going to be suspended. So under those conditions, yes, it is airborne. But by and large, once again, for the general public, I don't think the focus should be on airborne. I think that creates hysteria. I think it takes people away from common sense precautions like a mask, and it creates mayusi phail jati hai ek logon mein. Like people feel like nothing I can do. So once again, I strongly disagree, even with some of my physician colleagues, because I believe these are very important conversations. They just don't belong on Twitter and social media. Because we're trying to create unification here. Just unify the people around 80-90% of the facts and kill the pandemic. That's my focus.